HNL presents University of Hawaii Rainbow Football.
In seven games this season, Bob Wagner's Rainbows have experienced a season full of emotions. First, there was the high, the season-opening upset over Big Ten Iowa. And then on the downside, last week's heartbreaking one-point loss to WAC rival BYU. But the season is far from over, and with a 5-2 record, the Rainbows are in a peculiar position, seemingly out of the race for the conference title, yet within reach of an outstanding season and maybe even a bowl bid. And tonight, the Rainbows are hoping to take a step in that direction against the 49ers of Long Beach State, a team with only one victory so far this year, a team with the 92nd worst rushing defense in the nation, but a team the Rainbows haven't beaten in their last three meetings. From Aloha Stadium, it's Hawaii against Long Beach State.
Rainbow Football is sponsored by Coors, the original draft beer in bottles and cans. Coors, the original.
Hello again, everybody. I'm Jim Leahy along with Rick Blangiotti. Welcome to coverage tonight of the University of Hawaii against Long Beach State. Long Beach State, Rick, a team that has really struggled. They are on the brink. 2 years ago, they almost had to give up football, so Coach Larry Reisbig is holding on. He's having his troubles this year. This team has been batted around.
Well, Larry Reisbig is really a class guy, and you're right, Jim. 2 years ago, they almost pulled the program in December. He went out and spearheaded, along with some other people, the money to get this program back on its feet. Finally, last year, they got some scholarships back. I think a coaching perspective in this game is that he is going to bring this team out here tonight, decidedly the underdogs, but determined to try to at least improve and play a good football game. And that you have to respect.
Rainbows are coming off a very upsetting loss to BYU. Fans still feel it. No doubt the players still feel it. So tonight, going in against Long Beach State, the coaches, the University of Hawaii coaches, all week long have had to point out the fact that Long Beach State, despite being the underdog, has defeated the Rainbows in the last three meetings.
Yeah, but I don't really think that means a lot. I realize that that's been a tactic that's been taken in a psychology, because that's history. It's really tonight that counts. You have two teams, one that lost by 1 point a week ago and one that lost by 40. The question is, if looking at the perspectives and how people can play the game, will the same thing occur tonight? Hawaii should be good enough to dominate this game from the opening kickoff, and that's really the challenge for the coaches.
Rainbows are the overwhelming favorite. When we come back, we'll have the kickoff. Hawaii against Long Beach State. Stadium, Hawaii leads Long Beach State by a score of 21-16. We'll be back with the second half kickoff right after these messages.
Truck for KHNL's field camera is provided by Servco Pacific Toyota. Who could ask for anything more? Men's shirts provided by Tori Richard, Cook Street. And additional services provided by Diamond Head Ice in exchange for this announcement.
See the first half statistics. 221 yards through the air for Long Beach State, 150 for the Rainbows, 60 passing yards for the 49ers, 107 for the Rainbows. So when you add both of them up, even though it's very close on the scoreboard, is also very close in the statistics. Rainbows will kick off. Jason Elam gets the second half underway. And the ball bounces, finally goes out of bounds. That will be a penalty, and Elam will have to kick off from the 30-yard line. Mark Say was watching it.
Well, heads-up play by Say. Kind of gambled on that. I don't know how much of a difference it'll make with the 5-yard penalty, but that was pretty heads-up.
So the Rainbows, the overwhelming favorite going in. They were favored by as many as 20. They lead here 21-16. As we begin the second half. And the Rainbows were hoping to play some of their reserves tonight, players who don't usually get a lot of playing time. That is not the case going into the second half.
Nope, they're ahead on the scoreboard, behind in the stats, and I guess the key question is where are they in the momentum category and whether or not they can put this half together and dominate this game the way they should.
Kickoff by Elam, taken by Say at the 3-yard line. Trying to get outside, 30-31. Terry Whitaker again. Theo Adams also there, number 59. And Say very slow in trying to get up.
It was a nice 27-yard return, but he paid for it at the end. Here you take a look at Long Beach State's possessions, and I tell you, Jim, with all of that red up there, that's a lot more than they were supposed to have. And again, it's a credit to Graham, Jeff Graham, the quarterback, and engineering his offense and making things happen. That's a lot of offense for the first half for this young man and that team down there.
So Graham, 17 for 31, 221 yards in the first half, and he is now the all-time leading passer. Jeff Graham has taken over for Doug Gaynor. They're talking to Say on the sidelines. He will return. First down from the 31. Kelly Ryan is in motion. They throw to Ryan. Ryan trying to get a block. Does 35. And is out of bounds at the 39, but a penalty flag. May have clipping on Andre Sutherland.
I think you're absolutely right. Sutherland came over late. We'll wait for the call, but that's the way it looked for me up here.
Just joined us. Second half just underway.
Sweeney just gave the signal clipping. So that'll be a break for Hawaii, as I'm sure they'll accept the penalty and back up Long Beach State.
21 for the Rainbow, 16.
Now you see Sutherland come in right from behind on Whitaker. High block, not below the waist, but nonetheless a clip. Rule is the helmet can't be into the back.
16 for the 49ers as they come out on first down. And 20 from their 21. Browning out of the backfield is split to the near side. In motion goes Wiss, the tight end. Rainbows jump. They may have been drawn. Apelu is pointing. And Seomalo celebrating.
Directo is the guy that moved very quickly. I think it was right over the ball. The center might have moved the football. Dead ball. Take a look at it. Mr. Sweeney indicates what the penalty is here. Dana Directo, the nose guard, number 97, over the football. He makes the move. I guess he ruled that the ball was moved a little bit too much.
Greg Johnson to the near side. Kelly Ryan to the far side. It is now first and 25 from the 16. Graham to throw. Sets up the screen to Browning. He gets a block at the 20, 25, and is out of bounds at the 30-yard line. Excellent call, Terry Whitaker for the Rainbows, number two.
Good point, excellent call. Bo's really sort of waiting to tee off kind of defense.
Say is back into the game. He is flanked to the right, and Washington, Derek Washington to the left, standing tight end, is Wiss. He goes in motion. Graham again to throw, three-man pattern, now four-man pattern, throws Say off his hands, incomplete.
That's a break for Hawaii. Say knows it. Ball was right there, perfectly thrown, right through his fingers. Graham a bit frustrated. He's had more than...
You can see it right there. Rainbows do not blitz. Pitch goes to Browning. Trying to start the second half, and they get penalized because of the clip.
This is, we'll take a look at his block. I believe that's a clean block right there. That's the way to do it. He just puts that guy right down. We'll watch Walter with his run upfield and see if we can pick up the clip.
Tough to pick up the clip.
Might have been up on the top part of the camera. I'm not sure. I don't know. The flag was thrown upfield, and I don't believe it was on Lopati's block.
First and 10 for the Rainbows at their own 20. Hey, Cody Fakava in as the single setback. Fakava gets the call and struggles out to the 24. Mark Ziegenhagen, number 44. This is the Rainbow possessions in the first half. Three touchdowns. And you can see that they also enjoyed some success offensively in the first half.
Sure, the Bows with 21 points and a lot of offense with three touchdowns, and getting three touchdowns. Not a bad first half. I guess, again, the biggest thing is the fact that Long Beach State is within 5 points.
Second down and six. In motion is Junior Lopati. They overload the right side. Ball is given again to Cody Fakava. And he is able to run out over the 25-yard line and get to the 28. Lemuel Hawkins, number 92, the nose guard, 6'3", 245-pound junior out of Compton, California, came into the game with 27 tackles and two sacks, credited with the ankle tackle. That will bring up third down and three for the Rainbows. The ball just short of the 27.
Yeah, we were told during the half that, hey, Cody's injury when he went out in that first half was a cramp. And so he's okay.
Third and three. Ball is kept by Jones. He apparently has the first down. Able to twist and back his way to the 30-yard line. Mark Ziegenhagen able to upend him, number 44, for the 49ers.
It's going to be real close on the spot. Jim, I think you're right. It's going to be real close.
May not have it. Maybe short. Maybe short. And you can see that Jones arguing a little bit about the spot. Says, I thought I was over. Well, and so the Rainbows will have to punt it away.
He got flipped around there as he was going down, and he sort of went down, sitting down. And the way they placed the ball, he had his back at the stake. Wags, you can see over there arguing for it. Real close, real close.
So Kyle Alou, averaging 48 yards, gets this punt away. And it will take the Rainbow bounce. It's grabbed by Stacy Alexander. And he is hemmed in at the 30-yard line. 12:15 left to play in the third period. Hawaii 21, Long Beach State 16.
American Savings Bank has competitive rates on auto loans. So if you want to buy a Jeep.
Or a Maserati.
A station wagon.
Or Rolls Royce.
Just come into any branch of American Savings Bank. Why do you always do that?
Buy you.
Aloha. My name is Warner Kimo Sutton. I'm running for the 12th Senate District, St. Louis to Ina Haina. I want to represent you, not a major oil company or my own pet peeves.
The people of the 12th Senatorial District have had a difficult role. Their electricity is a roll over. Their Kalani-Anioli Highway is a roll under. And their cost of living is a bad roll. Let Warner Kimo Sutton go in and help you in the state senate. Thank you.
Aloha.
I've always wanted to drive a big rig like this one. I just didn't know where to get the training.
Hawaii Transportation Systems Professional Driving School offers local training in straight truck and tractor trailer operations. Our heavy vehicle driver training program is accredited by the National Association for Trade and Technical Schools. We even provide job placement assistance for all our graduates. We're a local program for Hawaii's truckers.
Give Hawaii Transportation Systems a call. I'm glad I did.
Remember, at the conclusion of tonight's game, Rick and I will be selecting the GTE Hawaiian-Tel Most Valuable Rainbow. Hawaiian-Tel will present $100 to the General Scholarship Fund of the University of Hawaii and the name of the player who went beyond the call.
Those guys look familiar.
Rainbow Wahine volleyball team. After two victories over San Diego State Thursday night and last night, preparing for a road trip where they will face the University of Pacific.
They play
and
great.
some of the men volleyball players too. They may be in line for a national championship. Graham to Washington. Good ankle tackle by Brian Belcher. Belcher, number 63, from Fountain Valley, California.
Well, I have to credit Brian at the outside linebacker position. Really hustled over there to make the tackle on the sideline against Washington. And Graham able to throw the ball, James, with quick drops, three steps. The offensive line for Long Beach State, we probably haven't given them enough credit. They have done a good job of giving their quarterback the time.
Ryan and Washington are the wide receivers. Ryan to the right, Washington to the left. Sheldon and Sutherland shift out of the I formation. Graham to throw. Two-man pattern, that's all. Throws up the sideline for Washington and overthrows him. Tevis is there. Belcher coming back, covering along with Odom on the near side. That will bring up third down.
Yeah, I have to smile at that because there's Brian again on the outside. Brian Belcher and Mark Odom, the inside linebacker. Both guys getting way downfield that time to help out young Chris Tevis. Don't usually see linebackers way downfield like that.
And you very rarely see only a two-man pattern. There's one on the far sideline and one on the near side.
They're trying to protect the quarterback to give him the time.
Washington and Say to the far side now. Back to pass, Graham. In trouble. Gets away yet another time. He may run. No, he'll throw. It is incomplete. We have a penalty flag down at the line of scrimmage.
I don't know if that'll be clipping. I think somebody might have clipped David Maeva. I don't know. I don't want to try to guess. I think it might be clipping against Long Beach State. Graham a little bit frustrated. I thought he was going to come up with a completion there as his receivers hurried to get into the patterns.
Wonder if it's in. No, it's holding. Holding against Long Beach State. That was very close to being an illegal forward pass. He was right at the line of scrimmage when he let it go.
Good look at him here. A little frustration coming up. A little quick thing with the head down. Tough. Can't say this guy's not a gamer. He's got his team into the game. He's playing hard on every play. Number 12.
Rainbows decline the penalty. And quickly, Long Beach State comes trotting on. They want to get this punt off. Rainbows trying to respond to special teams. Willie Lujan standing back inside the 20. Junior Lopati is deep for the Rainbows. Not Walter Briggs. There's the punt. Excellent hang time. Waiting for it as Lopati takes it at the 21. Fair catch. And the Rainbows will be there offensively.
47-yard punt. Long Beach State last couple punts. Really strong.
Very strong. I agree.
Hawaii, I think, I'm going to state the obvious, with 11-11 to go in the third quarter, needs to make something happen here with their offense to get it going, because Long Beach State is playing tough here in the opening rounds of the second half on a couple different exchanges. Offense needs to establish control of this ball game for Hawaii.
Roscoe is to the far side. He's picked up by Jenkins. And to the near side is Leonard Lau. He's watched by Alexander. Back to pass Jones. Now throws over the middle. Crossing pattern. It is complete to Roscoe. And he's down at the 39-yard line. Keith Washington making the stop. First down, Hawaii.
Now I'm going to say something I don't normally say in a broadcast. I'm going to say, yay, Chris Roscoe. Because the young man who dropped the two passes, particularly one just like this, a crossing pattern over the middle in the first half, comes back. And this is what it's all about. You come back and you do it. And boy, is he open.
And it's a good job that time. Good job of Jones selling the pass to the right side and then coming back to Roscoe in the crossing pattern. First and 10 from the 39. Jones to throw again. Jones has all day. Throws over the middle. It is incomplete. It was intended for Junior Lopati. And Lopati had slipped on the turf.
Yeah, Junior frustrated. He got himself open downfield deep. Two big deep patterns by Hawaii staff. Looking to set control, move that ball upfield in a hurry. Junior, got himself open, slipped, as you said. It was on the mat as the ball went whizzing by him.
Second down and 10. Jamie Collins, who caught his first pass of the season, flanked to the left. Leonard Lau, still looking for his first reception, is to the right. In motion is Junior Lopati. They overload the left side with three wide receivers. And the ball is kept by Jones, coming to the near side. Good move. 45, 50. He's got a chance. 45 bumps into Cody Fakava. And down he goes at the 40-yard line. Oh, he had an opportunity if he could get to the outside. But Fakava, running along with him, looking for a blocking opportunity, ran into him. And that stopped the play.
Tough break for Warren. Tough break for Cody having this happen. Here he puts on a good move. Real good here as he stops on the dime, cuts back across the defense, and now he's just about ready to turn into overdrive. And as Fakava tried to get upfield to throw, get in position to block for him, the feet and the legs got tangled up.
But it's enough for a first down for Hawaii at the 41-yard line of the Long Beach State 49ers. Roscoe and Lau, the wide receivers. The ball is kept by Jones. Pitch back, carrying the ball is Amani Davis. And Davis is able to slice inside the 35 to the 33-yard line. Davis out of Los Angeles and University High School, redshirt last year, nicknamed the Moose. He's big enough.
He is. He was tackled that time by Morrison and Patterson, the linebacker and secondary for Long Beach State. But Amani Davis, big-looking freshman. Big freshman. Redshirt freshman, but nonetheless freshman.
Second down and two. Roscoe to the left and again Lau to the right. Davis and Junior Lopati now in motion. They overload the left side. Jones keeps back the pass. Three-man pattern. Wants it long. Throws long over the middle to Junior Lopati. Interference will be called.
Well, that was almost a tackle on Lopati before he had the ball. I mean, that was major interference. And there you see Leon Patterson, sophomore defensive back. Big guy himself, 6'2", 200 pounds. That's kind of big for a defensive back. All over Lopati as we watch Warren. He gets good time. Going to throw the ball in the middle of the field. There you can see Patterson just actually putting the hands on Lopati, forcing him down to the turf. So brings up an automatic first down for Hawaii with pretty good field position. The ball should be on about the 18-yard line.
That's where it is. Daniel Lahuna comes in at one of the slot backs now for the Rainbows. Roscoe to the left and Lau to the right. Amani Davis and Lahuna in the slot. And the single setback, Cody Fakava. It is Fakava. Draws a crowd and a big pileup.
It's a pretty good hitting going on, though. The offensive line coming off the ball, even the backs coming up and blocking. The play only picked up 2 yards, but You can start to hear those pads bang up there, and I think that's a good sign for Hawaii. There's some intensity going with their offense.
9 minutes remaining in the third period. Score remains 21-16. That was the halftime score. The Rainbows now have the ball just outside the 49er, 16-yard line. Triple wide receiver to the left. Second down. Jones rolling, looking into the end zone. Jones comes back, now throws. Touchdown. Leonard Lau. That's his first reception. And it's a touchdown.
Well, you got to do it. You might as well do it with style. Young man from St. Louis High School, Leonard Lau, with a nice pattern as they were all over him in the coverage. And Warren, to his credit, found him and drilled the ball in there. And that man, Leonard Lau, with a nice catch as we take another look at it. What I like about this is the throwback. Warren rolls to his left where he's very effective, sets up now, looks back across the field, sees Lau, gets it off. Ball's thrown with authority, Leonard against good coverage. Stacy Alexander all over him, comes up with a clutch catch.
Lau had one reception last year for 25 yards, and now he has one in 88. Rainbow's going for two. Looking into the end zone is Jones, still looking. Now throws. Leaping attempt and unable to hold on is the intended receiver. And that's Leonard Lau. 8:35 left. Rainbows lead 27-16.
For auto parts that are simply the best, it pays to ask the ones who know. The counter pros at CarQuest. Like spark plugs and spark plug wires by Bosch. Bosch Platinum spark plugs and silicone shielded spark plug wires are known the world over for superior engine performance. And your Hawaii CarQuest auto parts stores have just the right Bosch parts at the right prices. Take the guesswork out of shopping for auto parts. Get the best from the counter pros at CarQuest.
I love Sandy Beach. Body surfing here for years. And if Sandys were threatened, I'd be the first to fight for it. But I know for a fact that years ago, Kamehameha Schools gave Sandy Beach to the people of Hawaii for us all to enjoy. So I don't understand this campaign to save Sandy Beach. The beach will be fine. But if this initiative passes, Kamehameha could lose its land marker of the highway. If you love Sandys, it's okay to vote no.
In recognition of the University of Hawaii's commitment to academic excellence, AMFAC is proud to present Touchdowns for Teaching. Each time the Rainbows score a touchdown, AMFAC will donate $200 to the University of Hawaii Foundation. These funds will be distributed to different colleges within the university for educational purposes. It's AMFAC's way of saying, let's go, boys, as we all root for a season full of Touchdowns for Teaching.
Second touchdown pass of the game. And also, it is the, as we said, the first, rather the 11th touchdown pass of the season for Warren Jones. First catch of the season for Leonard Lau. And we mentioned that Lau was the intended receiver on that two-point conversion. He was not. It was Daniel Ahuna who could not hold on, so we stand corrected there.
Well, there's a scoring drive, six plays, 79 yards, only 2.5 minutes. What I really liked about it, aside from that nice 16-yard touchdown pass, is the offense was determined when they got the ball. We said at the start of that series, at 11 left to go, to get upfield. That's a long pass plays, good blocking, real crispness, and they got in there, and they got in the end zone.
Jason Elam to kickoff, goes to Say at the 2-yard line. Here comes Mark Say, 10, trying to get to the near sideline, and he is twirled down by number 53, Joaquin Barnett.
Oh, Joaquin, boy, can he get downfield. The ball was taken on the 3, returned 9 yards up to the 12. Good field position, and I will say this is a challenge to this defense for Hawaii. With 8:29 left, they need to do exactly what the offense do. They've got to do something against Long Beach State's offense and make something happen. As we watch Joaquin Barnett just run through a wall of tacklers, blockers rather, and make the tackle on Mr. Say.
Walter Briggs has returned into the defensive secondary for the Rainbows. He had a twisted right ankle, but he is back in the lineup now. First down for Long Beach State at their own 13. Back to pass, Graham. Throws long over the middle. It is complete. Excellent catch by number 86, Brian Hamilton, the tight end from Redding, California. That is only his second reception of the year.
Well, he's all, He's only a freshman. I really like Jeff Graham. Boy, his offensive line gives him the time, but he knows right where to go. He looks off of one side, comes right back. He's got his tight end on a go pattern up the middle. They split the zone. He throws it beautifully. They pick up 33 yards. And what a nice first down play for Long Beach State.
Excellent way to come back for the 49ers. First and 10. Graham, sideline pattern. It is complete to Kelly Ryan. At midfield, gain of 5. Second down and 5.
I think Larry Reisbig just might have said the heck with the run here. They're going to just throw the football. And they're just coming out there just teeing off. Nice first down play again. Picked up 5 yards. A good execution. This kid has a good arm.
Oh, he does. He does. Long Beach State to the line. Washington, Derek Washington is to the right. And Alsay comes over here to the left. Single coverage. Chris Tevis picks him up. Double coverage on Washington. Rainbow showing blitz. They do blitz. Ball is given up the middle. Carrying the ball, number 32, Andre Sutherland. Sutherland went by the blitzing linebacker. Walter Briggs coming up from the defensive secondary and making the stop. That will bring up third down and 1. As Long Beach State now has the ball in Rainbow territory at the 46. Andre Sutherland. Sutherland out of Manassas, Virginia. That was the Battle of Bull Run, and that's the way he runs.
As we said earlier, a lot of people think he's an excellent pro prospect.
Third and 1. In motion is Sutherland. Ball is given to Lafayette Shelton to the 45-yard line.
Well, it's going
that
to be
could
close.
Could be enough for a first down.
Maybe. It was going to be pretty close, I think. Pretty good collision at the line of scrimmage. That's pretty much the same play that they gave to Shelton before when he scored the touchdown. Good. Now, here it is. Short yardage situation. Third and short. Both teams coming at each other. White shirts do a pretty good job of blocking. Somebody for the defense gets in there. A little bit of green penetration. Real close here. It's all in the spot.
So they will measure for the first down. 6 minutes, 50 seconds left. Third period. 27 for the Rainbows. 16 for the 49ers of Long Beach State. And Long Beach State is short. That will bring up fourth down.
Short by about 4 inches.
And they will go for it.
I like that. Why not?
So Kelly Ryan comes in with a play from the bench for Long Beach State. 6:50. Left third period, and now the Rainbow fans cheering for the stop here.
Well, this will be just a hard-nosed football play right here.
They flip-flop the tight end. Ball is pitched. This is Sutherland trying to get outside. Does he make it? Second, third efforts, he does make the first down.
Yes, he did. You're right, Jim. It was on that third effort, not the second, not the first. It was the third, but he made 3 to get there. He finally turned in the grasp of Chris Tevis and stretched it out over to pick up the first down. And I think the pictures say it all right here. You're going to run with the football. It's third and fourth and short. You want to make it. This is what you do.
There's Maeva grabbing him. Maeva pulling on him. And he lunges for the first down.
No, I said Tevis because I saw 35 at the end, but it was Maeva that he was able to outmuscle. Good call.
First down for Long Beach State. Say to the far side, Washington to the near side. Split backs behind the quarterback, Graham. Rainbows again showing blitz. They do not. Graham steps up in the pocket. Graham dances away. Graham will run. He's at the 40. Down he goes at the 37-yard line. Excellent play. Gain of 7. Brian Belcher finally tackles him. And Jeff Graham, all night long, he has impressed us with his poise, with his confidence, and now with his courage.
I like his eyes. He's got the good, clear eyes. Walking over to the sideline. I said a couple plays ago, he's got a real good arm. He's also got real good feet. Not only because of that run right there, but he's been stepping away from a lot of traffic all night long. And when he's had to run, he's run very effectively.
Ryan to the near side. Slotted inside of Ryan is Greg Johnson. Washington to the far side. Back to pass. Graham throws long. It is off the fingertips of Washington on the 16-yard line. 5:19 left, third period, 27-16 Rainbows. But Long Beach State has not let the Rainbows rest on their laurels.
There's Joe getting up rather slowly. Now, we have a nice replay on Sayumalo, who's been trying to put the pressure on Graham.
Sayumalo's still back in the Long Beach huddle.
Well, he's a little bit twisted there. I think he's probably going to come up to the sideline as he tried to give it all. He's pointing back there. Pretty good blocking up front, though, by Long Beach State. Now, he's a tough guy, boy. Jose Omalu, all year long, I think, has been one of the real pleasant surprises of the Hawaii defense in this 1988 season. He's just been real tough up front. I shouldn't really say surprise, but he's really kind of come into his own identity as a down lineman this year.
He has. Third and three for Long Beach State. And they call a timeout with 5:19 left. And the Rainbows leading 27-16.
Converse. FootJoy. E-Tonic. Kangaroo. Nike. Olympics. Reebok. JCPenney has all these great shoes at great prices. Run to JCPenney.
It's here. Maxima. Completely new. Completely redesigned. The maximum luxury sedan with tight European suspension, quality Japanese craftsmanship, American amenities, and American size. The 1989 Maxima, the sleek four-door sports touring sedan from Nissan. This is the one you've been waiting for.
McDonald's presents Holiday Huggable Muppet Babies.
Oh, did someone mention a hug, Kermit?
Right now, get your kids Baby Kermit, Baby Fozzie, or Baby Piggy. They're soft and huggable for a special price with any McDonald's food purchase.
Do you know where I could get a hug?
No, but if you sing a little of it, I think I can follow along.
Holiday Huggable Muppet Babies at McDonald's. A portion of the proceeds of each Muppet Baby plush toy will be donated to Ronald McDonald Children's Charities.
There you go. All I gotta do is put a number on this guy. He could fit in right there. That's it. He's having a good time tonight. I guess this is supposed to be a dinosaur. Bob.
either a frog, a toad,
or a
mutant ninja turtle.
There you go.
Third down and 3 yards to go. Ball at the 37-yard line of the Rainbow. Rolling is Graham. Throws. It is complete to Lafayette Shelton, to the 20, to the 18, first down Long Beach State.
Mike Colson's slow to get up. Good heads up by Graham, rolling to his left. Shelton just released out of the backfield, kind of as a hot receiver. Bose, I think, had some kind of zone coverage on because he just is able to catch this ball and turn up field. There he gets away from Wideantz. The ball gets just thrown up there. Not Wideantz, not...
That's Alalima.
Alalima, I'm sorry. And the ball is just upfield.
So Long Beach State has been able to move the ball now inside the Rainbow 20-yard line. First and 10. The ball at the Rainbow 18. Graham, the leader, back to pass. Gets away from Ieva. Throws. It is off of the hands of Washington at the 3-yard line. Washington airborne. Tevis back there contesting. And it will be second down and 10.
Derek Washington, the split receiver there, 6'3", 185 pounds. Good-looking athlete. I tell you, he's getting a lot of work tonight. He's getting work into a crowd and into a coverage. That time he ran a slant pattern right into the defense. Good-looking athlete.
Say is flanked to the right. Washington to the left. 23 completions for Graham. That's another record. Graham throwing. It is complete to Say. One-on-one. Say circles back toward the middle, then goes back toward the outside, and he's finally twirled down by Chris Tevis. They had isolated Say on Tevis, and the ball is now advanced to the 11. Jeff Graham has completed his 24th pass. That sets a Long Beach State career record of pass completions. This is number 571.
Say showing some good athletic moves. Tevis does a nice job of staying with him, wrapping him up, not taking the fake too much. Gets a help by Robertson and Maeva finally, but I think that Tevis would have made the tackle by himself. That was a good open field job against a very talented wide receiver.
Third down and four, the ball at the 12-yard line. Third and four. Washington to the far side, Ryan to the near side. Shelton and Sutherland are the split back behind Graham. Graham, hit by Robertson, sacked by Robertson. Eighth sack of the year by Robertson. And Gavin, out of Seattle, Washington, enters this week as third in the Western Athletic Conference as far as sacks is concerned, behind Matt Raybould of Wyoming and John Bell of New Mexico.
Early on in the game, we saw Gavin putting some real pressure on. I thought he would have had a couple by now already. Long Beach State, to their credit, kept him away, but not that time. That was a clutch third down sack by Gavin Robertson.
Van Steenkist in to try the field goal. They put the ball down on the 24-yard line. 34-yard attempt out of the hold of Paul Oates. It is down. It is kicked. And it is no good. That ball drifted to the right on Van Steenkist. And 3 minutes and 20 seconds remain in the third period. Hawaii leads Long Beach State by a score of 27 to 16. So the Rainbows stiffen now defensively, and they will put the ball in play at the 20-yard line.
That's
and, there, and there you see a young man who has danced tonight. He has been able to keep out of trouble from the Rainbow defense. He has been sacked just moments ago by Robertson, but he is still a very potent quarterback. First and 10 for the Rainbows. Jones now to throw. It is complete to Junior Lopati at the 35. Keith Jenkins there to force him out of bounds. That's a first down for the Rainbows.
Boy, Bo's going for some big plays. They got a holding penalty, though. It's going to negate a great reception and a nice execution by Jones. Tough break. That's frustrating for that man right there and the whole team for that matter. There you go, Rich. He's at work right now, boy. He is not happy. You see the veins bulging in the neck. That's, you know, coaches into the spirit of things. The bigger the vein gets as the game progresses, the more he's into it. That's about a one incher right there. You see it sticking it out? That's it. They don't want to mess with this guy. This guy was one heck of a football player. He's turning out to be a great football coach.
He's the defensive coordinator for the Rainbows. Put together an excellent game plan last week against Brigham Young. 27-16 the score. First down and 20 now for the Rainbows from their own 10. Jones lost the ball to Cody Fakaba up the near sideline to the 19. Phil Morrison able to cover him up there. That is short of the first down. Congratulations today to Washington State of the Pac-10, an upset of UCLA.
The oh.
Team UCLA led in that game 20-3, also 27-6, and they lost it 34-30.
You always say that because you know that Notre Dame will be number one in the nation on Monday.
No, I think Washington State should be you know, given credit. Good fight by Cody Fakava in the defensive secondary of Long Beach State.
No, I realize that, Jim, but this game is going back to prime ticket with all those people in Southern California just wincing at the thought of the, that school from the north upsetting their Bruins. Condolences, in a sense, to Terry Donahue and staff, because I don't think they were looking at that as a possibility.
Mauricio Gutierrez made the stop for Long Beach State. Third down and two. 2 minutes left in the third period. Jones again gives it to Cody Fakava. And they really rough him up. They mug him at the 28-yard line. Kane's there, number one, out of Laverne, California. And Dan Duffy out of Pacoima.
Dan Duffy, number 90, played a solid game. And Tom Jones, Tom Kane's number one down there. They've been tough against the run up inside. They're going to force Hawaii to punt.
Leo Goez still down for the Rainbows, and the trainers will have a look at him.
I didn't really mean to say that about not being a possibility. I want to go back to the UCLA thing, because anytime you play, and I think Washington State has played very well this year, so I'm sure the UCLA had their concerns, but they have also had an awful lot of momentum this year and played well in the big games. So,
and may still go to the Rose Bowl because they still have to play Southern California.
Sure.
Notre Dame still has to play Southern California.
That's true.
And so it's a banner year for Southern California schools, USC and UCLA right up there.
And this little one who came in here tonight, Long Beach State, in rather, you know, obscurity in the midst of all of that, is playing and putting in a rather game performance.
Let's put it this way. No one met them at the airport.
No one
yeah,
met
I mean,
them.
It's that kind of road trip.
Yeah.
Usually when you go on a road trip, there'll be some graduates there, some alumni there. somebody that is familiar with somebody getting off the plane. Possibly number 98, Pio Godinet, who went to high school at IAEA. Maybe his mother met him or his auntie met him, but no one else. And yet, here they are and playing well against the Rainbows. 27-16, fourth down and one. And Kyle Alou, well, out of Kamehameha into punt it away.
That last graph sort of said it all. Alexander with two returns for minus 0.5 yards, long return three. That's an interesting graphic.
Le Moitour, the long snapper. There's the kick. Wobbler comes up. Alexander lets it bounce, takes a rainbow bounce, plays it at the 23, gives ground. He is back to the 15, still giving ground. He's back to the 10, and Whitaker has him.
Oh, boy, his graphic just improved. What a big minus on that one. Good defense by Hawaii as they hustle down there. Poor Stacy Alexander, he tried to make something happen, but just got himself in a world of trouble. You can see the frustration. Too bad.
49-yard punt by Alou, and minus 10 yards on the return by Stacy Alexander. He was desperately trying to find some opening.
Yeah, he was.
And we have a penalty. Penalty called against Long Beach State.
This brings up a good opportunity, Jim, to mention that next week will be the homecoming game. So don't miss Homecoming 88, Alumni Mania, Saturday, November 5th on the UH Manoa campus from 3:30 p.m. to 5:30 p.m. Great food, fun, entertainment, and silent auction, including a round of golf with UH President Al Simone.
That in itself.
At the Neighborhood Miniature Golf
Holding
Club.
No, by the receiving team. During the kick, penalty were penalized from the spot where the kick ended, half the distance to the goal, first down.
I'm sorry, I was talking about Mr. Sweeney, but we did promise the Alumni Association we'd get that in. So next week against New Mexico homecoming, and a chance to have a round of golf with Al Simone at the Wailea Country
Club. That's real golf now. That's
real
not,
golf.
That's not miniature golf.
They're playing on a real golf course. Whether or not it's real golf still remains to be determined based on the performance.
First down, that penalty pushed Long Beach State back half the distance to the goal, so they're now back at the 9-yard line. Graham, single setback. In motion is Say, triple wide receiver now. They throw to Say, tries to get a block. Whitaker penetrates and dumps it.
Nice job by Captain Crunch out there. We've been saying Terry Whitaker's name a lot tonight.
He's Terry Whitaker there. Playing the game of the year for him.
Yeah, he's playing inspired. Actually, he's been a good player, but you're right, Jim. He's getting the opportunities tonight to really stand out because he's getting isolated on. Here they try to run a screen against him with one guy. He comes up on Say, has no part of being blocked, and makes a nice open field tackle. And he liked it.
Second down and 10, Washington now to the near side and to the far side. Number 82, Kelly Ryan. Browning and Bittner are the running backs. Bittner goes in motion. Back to pass is Graham. Throws. It is complete to Browning. 20. Good run by Browning all the way out to the 24. That's enough for a first down. Walter Briggs over to make the stop.
Well, that's a screenplay back to the other side. That time they were to get away and outside of Whitaker, who was the first guy upfield. And Browning does the rest. He gets some blocks, but it's really a nice effort of running by Browning with the football. As you watch here, he gets it. They get outside of Whitaker, as I said. He gets upfield now, and he's just not going to go down with anybody just grabbing at his shoulder pads. You're going to have to tackle him.
Say to the far side, Tevis watching him. McLeod to the near side watching Washington. In motion is Bittner, picked up by Whitaker. Back to pass, throw, and tipped at the line of scrimmage. It was intended for Wiss, the tight end.
I really like the way Long Beach State mixes up their pass patterns, though. You know, they got all kinds of different patterns. That time, just a little dump to the tight end, but somebody for Hawaii very alertly got a hand up.
Good defense in that line by the Rainbow. Second down and 10. We'll take another peek at it here.
See who gets the hand. Oh, it hit somebody on the head. It hits a hand somewhere. I just can't pick up the number, and I apologize to the player that made the effort.
Second and 10 for Long Beach State. In motion is Ryan. And we will have a penalty. Somebody moved on that offensive line for Long Beach. And legal procedure, dead ball foul.
False start, offense, 5-yard penalty, still second down.
3 seconds left to play in the third quarter. 27 for the Rainbow, 16 for Long Beach State.
I want to go back to the homecoming prizes. Aside from the chance to win a round of golf with Al Simone, which is probably the last prize, it's a weekend at the fabulous new Hyatt Regency in Waikoloa in the Big Island, and night viewing of the stars at the Mauna Kea Observatory and other products and services of UH campuses. And there I said it. That's,
you know,
my contribution to the alumni.
You know, that's not bad. A viewing of the stars from Mauna Kea.
No, that's why I wanted to get it in.
You know, that's not bad at all.
I know. That's why I wanted to say it, because the round of golf, by comparison, really wanes.
It pales.
Pales, yes.
Timeout for the moment called by Pat Sweeney.
Boy, Bob Wagner, I got to believe. You know, actually, in a way, this game here is probably pretty good, because of coming off of the loss of BYU, getting into this, if the boys can hang on to win, it's going to give them a lot of things to snap back into reality and work on before they play New Mexico next week.
Say to the right, Washington to the left. Second down and 15 from their own 19-yard line for Long Beach State. Graham to throw. Sideline pattern, Washington goes up, makes a fine catch. And a short gain. Kim McLeod there to bump him out of bounds. Number 19, that's the end of the third quarter. So the Rainbows leading 27-16 at the end of three. Long Beach State still within striking distance.
The challenger, Sheree Leonard.
I'm like his worst nightmare. I keep coming back to win again and again.
The WBC champion, Canada's golden boy, Donnie Lalonde.
After this fight, he won't want to come back again.
The motivation, not one, but two world championship belts in one night. November 7th, Caesars Palace, Las Vegas. Leonard versus Lalonde in a full tilt battle for all the gold. Brought to you by Coors Extra Gold Draft.
You know, years ago, my father showed me how to take apart a 56 Chevy engine. And now, I'm teaching Pete here a thing or two. Like these Napa replacement parts. They're the same as, or even better than, the original equipment. And most Napa parts come with a national lifetime warranty.
Yep, sometimes it is possible to improve on the original equipment. Right, Pete?
Right, Dad.
Whether you do it yourself or have a professional do it for you, ask for Napa.
You know, sports can open up a whole new world. A world built around working together for a common goal. Central Pacific Bank has been working with the people of Hawaii for more than 30 years, helping you reach your goals, helping you plan for the future. There's nothing quite like a full-service bank that knows you, plans with you, helps your dreams come true. Central Pacific Bank. You add up all the points, there's really no competition.
Matt Scudder, an ex-cop who won't be bought.
Sonny!
Caught in a world where everyone has a price. They sucked him in.
Talk. If I talk about something that interests me, okay?
Now his only chance, go for the man at the top.
I look like I need to make money, babe.
Jeff Bridges, Rosanna Arquette. 8 million ways to die.
Thursday at 8:05 on KHNL 13. KHNL's presentation of Rainbow Football is sponsored by Coors, the original draft beer in bottles and cans. Coors, the original.
Ah, yes. Halloween is approaching.
Yeah.
You know, of course, I've seen him here almost every week. He's like that every week.
I was going to say that. They're just giving him an excuse right there. That guy looks like that when he goes to school. He's one of the future leaders. I'll be voting for that guy someday, the way things are going right now.
We begin the fourth period of play, or we are about to begin the fourth period of play. 27 for the Rainbow, 16 for Long Beach State.
That's like among the volleyball players. Ben is a great athlete. So we should be nice there.
Third down and six from the 28 for Long Beach State. They trail 27-16. They want Washington. He's out in front. He has it. 40, 30. Will they catch him? No. Touchdown. Excellent play.
What a great play. Superlatives all the way around. Boy, Jeff Graham and company, a little hot dog in there. I don't know about that, but I got to tell you, what a great play. He threw that ball with a tremendous trajectory. We've got a 72, 73-yard reception, and he shows great speed. I said it earlier about this man. He's been running pass patterns all night into the defense, the junior wide receiver. The ball is thrown perfectly underneath him. And here he just strides it out and outruns the defense. That's a great play by Long Beach State. What a way to open up the fourth quarter.
Third touchdown reception for Washington. Now the seventh touchdown pass of the year for Graham.
And Mr. Graham may be on his way to a 400-yard game with those 73 yards thrown in right there, because he went over 300 some time ago.
So Graham really going crazy now at quarterback. That ball was placed right in there. And they had isolated Washington on Tevis. And Washington just ran away from Chris Tevis. I mean, he just blew by him.
At one point, there was so much trajectory there. It almost looked like a punt. He threw it that high. And we said right at the outset tonight, we were talking about, here you can watch it on the replay, about the kind of touch. He throws the ball hard. He throws it soft. Here he throws the ball. He lofts the ball beautifully with enough distance downfield to let Washington beat Tevis and then outrun Whitaker.
Very subtly, he had to slow up a bit to reach over his shoulder and catch the ball. He still had enough to keep the distance between himself and Tevis, and then Whitaker desperately trying to come over to help. 73-yard touchdown. It is now 27-22.
And I guess they're going to maybe go for 2 points here, which is the purpose of the timeout.
The ball is placed in the center of the field. I wonder if they want it on the hash mark. They do. They will put it on the left hash mark, or perhaps in between the center of the field on the left hash mark. That's where Graham wants it.
Yep, and let me give you a quick unofficial stat on Mr. Graham. 28 of 49 for 397 yards.
He is having himself a night. Washington to the far side, and to the near side is Kelly Ryan. Going for the two-point conversion. In motion is Browning. Graham gets away from Ayeba. Chased out of the pocket. Wants the throw. Now throws back over the middle. It is batted and caught. Two-point conversion caught by Browning.
Second ricochet pass tonight we've seen caught by Long Beach State. And Browning that time very alertly just persisted and hustled. And you have to credit Mr. Graham right there, Jeff Graham, because the pressure was on. Hawaii came with the blitz. He continued to scramble, maintained his poise, and got the ball into the end zone.
27-24.
Clearance sale. Clearance sale. Clearance sale. That's right. The Cutter team is having a clearance sale with thousands of cars and trucks to choose from. Prices too low to advertise. Every vehicle on every lot clearly marked. Some as low as invoice, and discounts up to $3,500 on Mitsubishis, Fords, Chevys, Dodges, Pontiacs, Jeeps, and Isuzus. Low financing and high trade-ins. Hurry for the best selection to any Cutter team location.
No matter how careful you are, accidents do happen. And when they do, you need help. Shudder and Glickstein.
In 1919, the Kaiser was out, and Spit and Polish was in. Some things never change. The young look, since 1902. In the 30s, innovation made young laundry the leader. Some things never change. Drop and go service. The young look, since 1902.
All right, now I don't think there's any surprise at all that he's going to pass the football. Hawaii anticipates that they're going to come with the blitz. But Graham right there very alertly gets away from David Maeva. Now scrambles. Now he's looking. He's looking. He's going to run away from the defense. He's still looking. He said, come on, guys, get open. He gets the ball off. Now the ball is off, and everybody goes up in the air for it, and Browning very alertly gets it. That's great effort by Long Beach State all the way around. They wanted that.
You'd have to go into the locker room and talk to Jeff Graham and ask him, when you let the ball go, did you have an idea? Did you throw it up for grabs? He may have just thrown it and said, well, here's a little prayer here.
Well, I think to Hawaii's credit, they did a good job of rushing him and covering everybody. Just one of the breaks of the game. What really is nice, though, is with 14:50, we have a three-point football game, 27-24.
Rainbows lead by only three. Gordon is deep for Hawaii. End-over-end kick. Pat Gordon comes up takes it at the 10, fumbles the ball, falls on it at the 15. So what Long Beach State has been able to do here in this game is very much what the Los Angeles Dodgers were able to do first to the Mets and then to the A's. Take positive things that happened to them, transfer it to the opposing team, and make that opposing team think about where they should be and how they should be playing, and it takes away from their effort, and we're beginning to see that tonight.
Wow, that was terrific. We watched the fumble right here. The Bo's lucky to get back on it. You brought the Dodgers into it. You had to do that. Okay.
First down for the Rainbows at the 15-yard line. Fourth quarter, they lead by only three. Jones to throw. Throws long. He wants Amani Davis. Throws it too far. Davis can't get to it at midfield. Covering on the play, Leon Patterson. It has started to drizzle here at Aloha Stadium. 14:41, and the drizzle comes in perhaps as an omen, perhaps as a sign, the way the Rainbows were supposed to handle this game. And Long Beach State has cozied up. 27 for the Rainbows, 24 for Long Beach State. And now the crowd here starting to pop the umbrellas. Second down and 10. The ball is given up the middle. Billy Stevens, 20. Billy Stevens breaking tackles out over the 25 to the 27. That's enough for a first down. So Billy Stevens running as a fresh back in the game.
He always has that great intensity, too, that style of play. He just wants to bounce up, go in there and hit somebody good upfield. He's just a nice player. And that time there, he did exactly that. And I got nothing against the Dodgers. I'm just kidding. I know you just, the way you were so caught up in the World Series.
But in analyzing the way.
No, it was great. Well, let me say one thing here as we watch the Bulls line up for the play in the ISO on Stevens here. I want to say one thing about what they supposedly didn't have as a team. I'm talking about Long Beach State here as they make the tackle. Is that last week, the big criticism, what they said, starting with the head coach, was we played without emotion, okay? And that supposedly went on to be the nemesis as the game went on and they got beat 40 to nothing. They have every reason to have maximum emotion right now, as they were well within the opportunity of winning this football game.
So one of the Rainbows down, that's either Leo Goes or Doug Paho.
I think it's Doug, 69, Paho.
And it is Paho, out of Kaiser High School here in Honolulu. Rain coming down quite heavily now. This is the first real rain that we've had during the course of the season. Here in the final days of October, 13:55 remaining to be played in this game, and concern now for Doug Paho as they assist him, but he appears to be okay as he is walking under his own power. And so the Rainbows will have second down and 10 on the ball at the 28-yard line and leading in this game by only three, 27-24. Lopati, Roscoe, and Amani Davis are wide to the near side. To the far side is Leonard Lau. Back to pass is Jones. He's hit, gets away. He's at the 30. He'll run. Has the first down. He's at the 40 and out of bounds at the 44. And he's hit after he went out of bounds. Looking for the flag. No flag. Kane slid out of bounds with him and made contact.
I'll tell you, Leonard Lau threw a real key block for him, let a little bit in that run up there field to help spring him. But Warren would have picked up the first down. That's real heads up football play by Warren Jones here.
You see Mauricio Gutierrez really put the pressure on him, actually grab him.
Well, there he breaks a tackle. He gets a little bit of help with a block. Now he's going to go upfield, and Lau comes over and just puts on the real nice block. Warren picks up the first down.
Well, you see the contact out of bounds. First down for the Rainbows just short of their own 45-yard line. Ball is given to, no, kept by Jones, and Jones ducks it up for 2 yards over the 45 to the 46-yard line. Rain continues to come down with 13:20 left to play here in the fourth quarter. And a very concerned Bob Wagner on the sidelines. Very concerned.
Well, this just goes to show you that this game is played by young men. Anything can happen on a Saturday night. And it's just real interesting to watch.
Jamie Collins and Chris Roscoe now the wide receivers. Jones pitches to Collins. He needs help as he comes to the near side. Doesn't get it. And down he goes at the 49-yard line. Gain on the play of only 2.5 yards.
Well, Phil Morris and the linebacker really made the nice play. He was the one that was able to get upfield and be in real good position in the pursuit pattern to take on Collins, and he did exactly that. He made the open field tackle.
And one of the Rainbows is down on about the 48-yard line of Long Beach State. take a look at Philip Morrison. We cannot see from our vantage point the number of that particular rainbow.
Is it 17? Hekoti Fukava.
It may be Hekoti Fukava, and this is much more serious than usually when we see Fukava either out with a cramp or maybe a twist. He is down. And yeah, concern now for Hekoti. He has.
They're working that knee a little bit there, the pressure on his knee. See, they're grabbing the ankle, but they're putting the resistance on the knee. Now they're going up on the knee. Real concern. Now, the surface has gotten a little bit slick out here. It may have been that Hekoti might have just sort of lost it and got it twisted because of this rainfall. And the rain is coming down pretty heavy, as you can just see in your camera, in the picture there. Concern now for Fukava. He is so key to this offense.
He's a very resilient young man. He has been carried off the field time and time again in his career, only to come back into the lineup and to be a positive force for the Rainbows.
He's such a good young guy, too. He's always got a, you know, the smile on his face, the positive attitude. Just hope he's okay.
So Fukava leaves with 12 minutes and 40 seconds left, and he is not putting any pressure at all on that right leg. None.
It's not a good sign at all. Rain has now just stopped as quickly as it started, and Billy Stevens, it looks like we'll have to go the rest of the way for the Bows.
And worry etched now on Bob Wagner. Third down for the Rainbows. Jones to throw. Giving ground. Chase. And Keynes has him. Dumps him back at the 35-yard line.
Boy, Keynes just maintained his position. A little pushing after the play. And just was able to keep up with Warren and make the open field tackle.
So Tom Keynes out of Laverne High School. He graduated from Damien High School in Los Angeles.
This Keynes now just showing some strength. See, one hand, he gets that left hand there, but he didn't want to let go and just pulls it down. Great hand strength. Real determination.
11:56 left. Alou roots it out. Good hang time by Alou. Stacy Alexander waits. Takes it at the 20. Trying to come to the near side. Robert Land hits him as he gets to the 25. And he stumbles forward to the 26-yard line. We may have a penalty flag, and we do.
45-yard punt by Alou. I'm not sure what the call is going to be. Is Stacy Alexander a little bit frustrated all night? He's frustrated again.
So now Long Beach State, 1-6, a team that has really been battered on occasion, a team that has suffered almost embarrassing defeats, has a chance here.
Dead ball, spearing on the defense, 15-yard penalty, first down.
Well, the Bows don't want to self-destruct. This guy right here has got lots of confidence right now. I mean, after the last pass to Washington, keeping his team within three, passing for nearly 400 yards, you know what's going on in his head right now is, hey, guys, we're going to win this game. Somehow the guys in the green have got to shut down this man right here, number 1-2 for Long Beach State.
11:42 left to play in the game. First and 10 for Long Beach State at the 43-yard line, their own 43. Johnson to the far side, Say to the near side. And the quarterback is Graham. In motion is Browning. Graham to throw. Throws long over the middle, and we may have interference. And we do. It was intended for Brian Hamilton, the tight end, and Terry Whitaker tripped him up.
Yeah, it was inadvertent, unfortunately, but they've run with that go pattern a lot against the zone tonight, both with Wiss and Hamilton, tight end going straight up the field. And absolutely right, Jim, as we look at Terry Whitaker there, he just got into the feet of the tight end. So as we look at it right now, Hamilton's just going to run a go right up the straight, running up the hash mark. Going to come for the football to the inside. Whitaker was into his body, and they call the interference. So it's going to give Long Beach State first down inside Hawaii's side of the field, Hawaii territory.
Ball is advanced to the 42-yard line of the Rainbows. Hey, Cody Fukava, screen right knee. His return in this game is doubtful. Washington to the left, and Kelly Ryan to the right. In motion is Ryan. Double wide receiver now on the left side. Ball is given up the middle to Browning. Able to break one tackle and get inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. Wes Alai Lima. 6'10", 210, the senior linebacker. Graduate of Stadium High School, Stadium, Washington. in on the play of 3, 2nd down and 7.
Well, we have 11:15 left in the fourth quarter. Maybe one of the things that may come back to haunt Long Beach State is that they only have one timeout remaining.
Same wide receivers. 2nd down, Graham short drop, in trouble. Graham to the 38-yard line. That time, Dana Directo, number 97, 6'2", 258-pound junior, would not let him go.
But the guy that really made it happen, as Directo gets credit for the tackle, was Seumalo on the penetration. He was in there in a flash. And Big Joe, as we watch it now again on the replay, has been the guy right here. He's going to get Graham out of the pocket in a hurry. Seumalo really giving a game effort.
3rd down and 7. Ball just inside the 39. Big third down play here for Long Beach State. Graham short drop, quick pattern, sideline, throws it short. Intended for Kelly Ryan. That will bring up 4th down for Long Beach State.
And the Long Beach State coaches on the other side of the field were pointing to Graham that Derek Washington, the ball is a completely overplayed to that side of the field. Washington was all by himself up here in the near sideline. Only Graham never saw him.
Willie Lujan, the punter, comes in for Long Beach State. And Walter Briggs goes back, backpedaling, and he will end up inside the 10-yard line. Waiting for the snap from center. 10:23 left to play in the game. Lujan angling for the corner. Goes into the end zone. Rainbows will have the ball at their own 20-yard line and leading in this game, 27-24. 39-yard punts. So now the Rainbows operating without Hekoti Fakava, but with Billy Stevens out of Konawaena High School in Kailua Kona on the Big Island of Hawaii will be the lone setback. Goas has returned to the lineup. Doug Pa'ahau with a strained knee. He is not back in there. Mark Nua taking his place. And so it is 1st and 10 from the 20. Jones to throw. Three-man pattern. Jones wants it. He wants Wasco. He's open at the 45-yard line.
What a great catch. He just beat Stan Davis, the cornerback, on man-on-man coverage downfield deep. Offensive line gave Jones the time that he needed. And Warren threw one of the best-looking passes of the night right here as he burned Stan Davis with Chris Roscoe. Here you can look at it coming into the screen. Chris just great attention on the football, great concentration, gets hit and comes down with it.
Great catch by Roscoe. Now the Rainbows have the ball at the 44-yard line of Long Beach State. Jones looking over the defense. Gives it, no, keeps it. Jones at the 40. Jones 35-yard line and very close to the first down. Mark Ziegenhagen there to make the stop for Long Beach State.
Two big plays by Warren Jones. The pass to Roscoe was beautifully thrown. That time he ran the option beautifully. There's a good tight shot of Wagner boy saying, come on, guys, get it going. Get it going. Let's get in there. It's just three stuff. Look at that clock. I'll tell you, the life of a head coach. You know, he ages a lot more than 3 hours in the course of a game, I guarantee you.
He does. It's almost time-lapse photography watching him. 9:17 left. And on the other side, the age starts to show on the Long Beach State coach.
Dead ball. False start on the offense. 5-yard penalty. Still 2nd down.
Long Beach State coach, of course, Larry Reisbig. And these two coaches looking at their respective teams tonight. It will be interesting when we talk to Coach Wagner tomorrow about what he thinks about the Rainbow performance in this game, no matter if they win or lose. That'll be at 4 o'clock tomorrow afternoon, Hawaiian Standard Time. 9 minutes left. 2nd down and 6. Jones keeps. Pitches to Junior Lopati. No gain, maybe one, a gain of one. Stacy Alexander there to plug it up. 8:46 left. Rainbows cannot afford to get too conservative to try to run the clock because we have seen evidence of the potential of Jeff Graham and his wide receivers.
Yeah, I don't think, you know, to their credit, they've been really conservative on this drive. We've had some nice plays. What they've got to do right now is simply convert on a 3rd down situation.
Exactly, as they come out. Leonard Lau to the far side. Touchdown pass in this game to the near side, Roscoe. Jones, Roscoe, batted, almost intercepted. He was out of bounds. Phil Morrison.
Boy, Morrison's really come alive in the second half right there. He just didn't have possession, as you like to say, but he actually had the interception. He went out of bounds with the ball. This is the way a linebacker's supposed to play. Get the hands up, knock it down. See how high in the air he went for that? Boy, he's like a center fielder robbing a home run.
And he didn't have possession when he went out of bounds. That brings up fourth down for the Rainbows on the 39-yard line of Long Beach State. It is fourth down and five, and the Rainbows have called a timeout. So now the Rainbows will have two timeouts remaining. Long Beach State has one, and the Rainbows continue to lead with 8:12 left in the fourth quarter by only three.
You gotta go.
Go where you want, do what you want. Bank of Hawaii is there with 60 convenient offices close to home, near work, and most anywhere you want to go.
You gotta go where you want, do what you want, go where you want.
Bank of Hawaii is the most convenient place to bank.
We take people and they enjoy it from age 8 up to age 80, and they all have the same look in their eye when they leave. Makaha's a magic valley.
I think most of the staff here promotes one thing, really, to see that the guest is pleased, to see that they enjoy their stay, and above all, to see Hawaii as it should be.
The Sheraton Makaha Resort and Country Club, where little things mean a lot.
The crowd of 37,498.
I thought we were showing all the people that went to Halloween parties tonight.
8 minutes and 12 seconds left. Fourth down for the Rainbows, and they are going to gamble. Leading 27 to 24. They have the ball at the 39-yard line. They have to go just inside the 34 for the first down. Jones running. Throws. Roscoe falls down. Long Beach State takes over. Look for flags. There are none.
It was there. Too bad for Chris.
And another question. Could Jones have run for the first down?
Well, if you look at the replay, it seems like he's got a lane out there. They were playing for the pass. Somehow, miraculously, Chris got himself wide open up the sideline. Nobody played him, but he fell down. And the big key here now is that Long Beach State not only holding on fourth down, but now has real good field position with the ball in the 39. 8:05 left to go in this ball game.
Washington and Say to the near side as wide receivers. First down from their own 39. Graham to throw, rolling out of trouble. Throws, crossing pattern. It is complete to Lafayette Shelton. And Shelton is hit by Colson, Michael Colson. He's out of Long Beach, California, Long Beach City College.
Good job by Colson as Lafayette Shelton got himself open in front of Ali Lehman, a linebacker, but Colson came over to close, but not before they picked up 5 yards.
Ball is now at the 44-yard line, second down and five for Long Beach State. Shelton and Browning. No, check that. Sutherland. This is Sutherland battling for the first down, and he will be very close. Mark Odom there to force him back.
Boy, you know, there's some real good hitting. You know, I think at this point in the game, Jim, one of the things that's real key now, Hawaii would have decided advantage 5-2 going into tonight's ball game right here. Long Beach State 1-6 becomes a question of knowing how to win and whether or not Long Beach State really thinks they can win.
That's a good point. Very good point. That is enough for the first down. So Long Beach State will have the ball at almost at midfield. We'll call it the 49-yard line. In Long Beach State territory, and 7:17 left in the clock ticking. Washington to the left, Say to the right. Graham, nothing on the right, looking left, now running up the middle. And Wesalai Lima, Augie Pelu there to roll him to the turf inside Rainbow territory. And the clock continues to tick now, 6 minutes, 54 seconds left in this game, and the Rainbow's leading 27-24.
This guy on just one play right there, Jeff Graham, number 12, with over 400 yards passing tonight. We've seen it already. He can make it happen on only one play. What a dangerous player.
Browning started to go onto the field, and then he turned around and came back out. Rainbows go into a nickel defense, five defensive backs. Sutherland in motion. Graham looking for Sutherland. Checks off. Throws for Washington. Complete inside the 40 to the 38-yard line. That is enough for a first down for the 49ers.
Well, against man on coverage there, Washington got open and Graham got away from the blitz. And Long Beach State offensive line did just enough to allow him the time to do it. As you said, they're playing with five guys, but there's the blitz. You see the two backers coming. People are dropping off. Now, they're supposed to be in some kind of man coverage. They're going to come off there, but he played a little bit, Colson played a little bit too much off of Washington, and Graham found the open receiver.
First down, Long Beach State at the Rainbow 38-yard line. Ball is given to Sutherland. And he is hit at the line of scrimmage and then wed sideways by Mark Odom. Odom there along with Brian Belcher. No gain on the play. Well, they're going to give him a yard. Second down and one.
Very important series for Hawaii here. This defense has got to get real tough.
5:36 left to play and the clock running. Kelly Ryan to the far side, Washington to the near side. Graham, another short drop, throws, look in pattern. Ryan cannot hold on. Oh, he was in between defenders, in between Briggs and McLeod at the 21.
Get open in the zone, and Graham knew just where to go. He had Ryan right there, the ball, it's a little bit behind right there.
Tickets sold tonight, 37,498. Turnstile count, 31,371.
And there you just saw a stat right there, Mr. Graham, with 416 yards passing. What a night he's having, and he's not through yet.
Third down and nine from the Rainbow 37-yard line. Big play here. Graham almost stumbled. Throws. Incomplete fourth down. It was intended for Sutherland out of the backfield. Belcher, the linebacker, able to cut in front and make sure that ball was out of bounds.
When they look at the films, what they're going to find is that number 21, Lafayette Shelton, the fullback, was wide open on the left side, almost in the middle. He just never saw him. They got to go for a field goal from here, Jim. And Graham, you can see, kind of frustrated talking to the coaches. He wanted to go upfield. They're going to go for a long field goal.
They put the ball down at the 44-yard line. Van Steenkist. This is a 54-yard attempt. It struggles. It will be short. Rainbows will take over.
I tell you, I think fourth and nine. I don't want to second guess Larry Rice, but I think fourth and nine in this situation with the game of the balance versus a 54-yard field goal, I try to go for the fourth down play. You're going to turn the ball over at the same position on the field anyway. I think I try to play the running play because or the play itself and not kick a field goal.
Could be.
Well, I think it could be.
It could be, and you know, I'm not here to second-guess anybody.
No, I'm not second-guessing either. I'm just saying a 54-yard field goal is pretty, percentage-wise, pretty low.
Unless he makes it. It's first down for
sounds
the Rainbows.
Like you've been listening to the political debate.
At the 37-yard line. Oh, I love this. Here is Jones, big hole, 45, 50, and he's all the way to the 46-yard line. Oh, the people that sit in the stands and analyze coaches' moves.
I don't sit in the stands. I'm up here. As we watch Jones run a nice option right here, he steps up inside. He's had this run as he picks up 18 yards all night tonight. Warren's had a real good night at running the option, and they've actually given him the lane. He's taken advantage of it.
I would have punted. First down for the Rainbows on the 45-yard line of Long Beach State. Billy Stevens. Stevens from the 45, perhaps to the 43.
Now, at 4:30 left to go, or 4:33, with only one timeout left by Long Beach State, quite the amount of drive here, they could almost make it impossible for them to even see the football again.
That's true. That's true. Pat Quigley and Mark Ziegenhagen. Double team Stevens on that last play for Long Beach State. Second down.
And that could be your best defense is keeping Phil Graham off the field.
Jamie
Jeff
Collins,
Graham, rather, I'm sorry.
To the far side and Roscoe to the near side. Jones keeps. Pitches back Amani Davis. Needs help. Down goes the big fella at the 42-yard line. 3:56 left. 27 for the Rainbows, 24 for the 49ers of Long Beach State. Jones tonight, 13 of 24, 229 yards and two touchdowns.
And he must be running for somewhere 80, 90 yards up there too as well. That was good defense that time by Long Beach State, though. They played the option real well, both on Jones and on Armani Davis, the pitch guy.
Third down and seven for the Rainbows. 3:29 left to play in the game. Rainbows lead by three. Long Beach State blitzes. They pick up the blitz. Long pass. He wants Roscoe. And the ball is intercepted. Intercepted by number 27, Keith Jenkins. And they are going to say that is a legal interception and also a touchback. And the ball will be brought out to the 20-yard line. And for Warren Jones, that is his sixth interception of the year. Well, excellent coverage by Keith Jenkins out of Oakland High School.
All right, now this is great here because we've got an isolation on Chris, the intended receiver. There you see him going to work on Keith Jenkins. Chris has been very effective against the man-on-man coverage. Here it is, Jenkins playing about as tight as you can play it. He had the inside position. The ball was thrown that way, and Jenkins came up with a great interception.
They're not going to bring it out to the 20. They're going to give him the Long Beach State the ball at the 3-yard line. I thought I saw a touchback. That ball is almost intercepted, almost picked off by Kim McLeod. It was intended for Kelly Ryan.
Tough break for McLeod, not getting an interception, but nonetheless, very good defense by Kim, who's back into the game after missing the last several weeks due to an injury. That time, he very alertly stepped in front of the football.
Michael Newsom, number 83, wide receiver, has come into the game. He's out of Hempstead, New York. He's picked up by McLeod. Second down and 10. The ball at the 3-yard line with 3:12 left. Graham to throw. Over the middle, it is complete crossing pattern to Lafayette Shelton. Shelton is out over the 10 to the 13-yard line, and he is right on the mark for the first down. Wesley Lima there to make the stop for the Rainbow.
First down, good play, good ball. They got the balls dropping back. Just hit him underneath. His hot receiver coming out of the backfield, and there you see clock. Time is the biggest factor right now. Long Beach State with only one timeout left. They've got to go some 86 yards in order to get into the end.
Washington McClatt, six against Colson on the right. First down from the fucking Graham. Right. Rolls along up the sideline for Say. Off his fingertips. The pass was thrown. Colson tried to come over.
He was late.
Holding against Long Beach. It's a legal shift against Long Beach State. Because the way the flag was thrown real quick, like by the official, like, it was against the offense. It was just a matter of what the call was going to
be. 30 seconds left. Scary up the near sidelines because
it was open.
Well, you know about this offense and Jeff Graham and everybody else out there is not afraid to do that. They're right upfield. They got the big one. They're not, you know, they're just mixing up the passing plays
all over the place
for another long one like they had to Washington earlier.
Climbed by the Rainbows. And Kelly Ryan are the wide receivers. Graham looking. Throws over the middle, crossing pattern to Washington. 40. He may score. The 32. The 25. The 10. Touchdown.
Beats the
30-27, and they
struck
very quickly, very dramatically, and perhaps very decisively. Here in the final minutes.
Well, I'm not sure, but Jeff Graham might have gone over 500 yards with this pass right here. This is just a great
Washington.
We said all night he's going to go right to the defense. He's running a slanted pattern across the zone. He catches it. He just turns around, and now for the second time tonight, he just outsides the defense As Marco, you know, matching the speed department with that kind of lead, Derek Washington, 8 receptions, 207 yards, and Graham is over 5 yards.
Ready for the try for excellence. 30-27, kick is... And Van Steenkiss drills it.
It is now
31-27, Long Beach State.
And unofficially, Graham with 507 yards to take this break.
What a performance.
Everywhere you look these days, there's another player working out Richard Fields on break jobs. He looked into them,
but he came to Midas. And he's not alone. A million others trust Midas too. For good reason. Because...
game of field goal won't do it. There you see it, four plays, 97 yards in less than a minute. Graham with a second big pass to Washington, this time for 86 yards. And Jim, I have it unofficially, Graham is 32 of 57 for 507 yards, three touchdowns. What an amazing performance, probably an Aloha Stadium record as well.
Oh, I would think so. And perhaps crowding in on the all-time opponent record in throwing against the Rainbow. Has to be close.
Up there, really up there. Derek Washington with a couple hundred yards in catching. That is a big way tonight.
Inkins kicks off, 31-27 Long Beach State.
Fumble return.
Pat Gordon pumps into his own blocker, and down he goes at the 27-yard line.
Well, this guy right there, he's done it all for the guys in white from Long Beach State tonight. Done it all but officially one. That's official. 513 yards, two TDs. I was told three. Now it's up to the guys' team. This guy may not score again. There's 2:14 remaining. Warren Jones and company, if they're going to win this ball game, they're going to put it into the end zone some 73 yards away.
And there you see the first and 10 from the 28.
In motion,
Ohuna. Jones to throw. Looks. 30. Get out of bounds. Short
first down.
207 left.
Lapati getting out of bounds. Bows have two timeouts remaining. 207. The clock, the big factor. The clock and Long Beach State's defense.
Right here, Warren Jones must make the correct decision. Bottle from the Rainbow. Second down and two for the.
Bosco and Leonard Lott trying to the run.
Ball is given to Billy Stevens. He has the first down. That will stop the clock.
2-1.
The fans are booing, but I don't think you understand what the strategy was there. Pick up the first, stop the clock, regroup the guys before it starts. Here they go. Quick cuddle. They're on the line of scrimmage.
That clock still ticking away now. 1:53. Jones wastes too much time. Back to pass. Warren Jones throws. It is complete to Ohuna. He's hit at the 40-yard line. He does not get out of bounds. 144, 143. Jones trying to gather the troops back. 139. There you see the clock. 31 for Long Beach State. 27 for the Rainbows. Rainbows at desperation time. Second down and one for the first down.
Jones
looking to the sidelines. Throws
Roscoe.
Roscoe has it, but he's out of bounds. Incomplete. That stops the clock with 1:23 left. And we have a penalty flag.
It's roughing the quarterback. We'll take a look at it.
Roughing the passer. Roughing the passer against Long Beach State.
That'll be a break. It'll give him an automatic first down. As we take a look at it, Warren now, he gets the ball off. Keynes is coming in there. I guess a little bit too much action right there. That gives him the ball way downfield now. Bulls have got a chance with minute 23. They've got more than a chance. I think the real key here, Jim, is from their boys. That is the key, because they are within striking distance.
1-3 left the play. 31 for Long Beach, 27 for the Rainbows. The ball just short of the 36-yard line. The wide receiver to the left, Roscoe, near the side. Jones looking for Roscoe. Now in trouble.
Jones throws his side.
It is to Leonard Lyle, his second reception of the year, and he is very close to the first down.
On the 20-yard line.
A long, good job by Jones.
Looking
left, nothing developed. And then he turned quickly and rifled the ball to Leonard Lyle, and Lyle is down.
Lyle's injured. It's going to stop the minute 14. You're right. Jones looked at the field before he found Leonard Lau, and when he did, he delivered the ball right on the money.
This is a big test for the Rainbows, a big test for their mettle, for their poise,
for their pride.
And they will measure for the first down.
I think he's got the first down. Boy, this is here. 74 seconds. It's a lot to think about. They've got to come up with the play. They've got to get in the end zone. Keep in mind, the team from Long Beach State went 90-some-odd yards in less than a minute. So there's plenty of time left to go the remaining.
The two timeouts to Long Beach State's only one.
And maybe now I raise a point that I raised earlier, perhaps really. And that is, well, this team in white thinks that they can, having been on the bottom end of the score many times, and the team in green would have decided to now.
Team in green, they can win.
Well, I know, but they've been winning it. They've got to see us versus only once for the other guys. Long Beach State, 10 penalties on 5 years. If that means anything.
One team left. Rainbows.
First down and 10. Wide receiver of the Rainbows. Wallace kept it. Pitches back. I'm sure of it. The 20. He's right about the game.
Davis, you some tackles. You all
talk
it all the way.
No, Paul,
there. You can see the
whole
white coach.
27. Drama. When we're back. I figured out why Bob Wagner eats tacos. Beefy like a burrito. Taco burrito. They could have called them Baraka.
Introducing new Mexican finger food tacos. Shredded in a rolled corn. Only Jack in the Box. Frank said.
Hey, Tupito! We train the
great fight by Holt.
33, 31. Now the question comes up, with this Rainbow leading by two, do you go for two?
Question.
Or do you go for one?
I don't know.
If you go for one, they can still tie with a field goal.
Did you see the quick shot of Greg by licking his finger to get back into the game? This man with the guy with the football left wins.
Elam puts it up. It is now 34-31. Rainbows with 49 seconds left. The Rainbows go 72 yards. The 1 yard run by Warren Jones. Jones has played well in rushing the ball tonight, but the performance of the night belongs to Jeff Graham of Long Beach State. This night he will remember. He will remember because of how he has performed, the yardage total, the records that he has set.
I agree. And I don't know, even though Hawaii had some deficits coming into this game, the national ranking 100 pass defense, and as prolific as Graham has been as a quarterback, his most ambitious moments thought, I'll go in there tonight and throw for 500. And he's done that.
He scored a mini season tonight. We take a look at the touchdown by Warren Jones. Jones able to power into the end zone behind the block of Larry Jones.
Good swag. You gotta love this job, Bobby Wagner. Right here. Good. Yes. Okay. There you go.
But still, 49 seconds for Jeff Graham.
And company.
So you see 72 yards in 7 plays. A minute 25 seconds in elapsed time. Jones with a 1 yard run. Excellent decision making all the way through those 72 yards by Jones in delivering the ball and by the receivers. And also, you have to say, Imani Davis on that drive may have come of age.
Couple big plays by Imani Davis, the redshirt. Your parents are, hey, Cody, for coming for graduation. Really played well when needed. Probably, maybe will become one of the real bright spots in this game coming out of it if they can hang on to win.
49 seconds left. The Rainbows playing the Long Beach State 49ers.
Well, now I say, as we just saw both Raymond and Jones, we wait here. They're going to show it. Very interesting.
This is Say. Say runs into Odom, and Odom holds on. Say carries him out.
That was
the 22-yard line.
The wrong guy to run into as we watch Jeff Fisher appeal with his stats. Unbelievable stats on this. We just saw Jones. We saw Graham. Jones did his job. Now the question is, can the defense stop Graham from doing any more damage than he's already done?
42 seconds left. No timeouts remaining. Back into the game for the Rainbows. The ball is on their own 22. Say and Washington are the wide receivers. Graham to throw. Three-man pattern. Graham throws up the sideline for Browning. Incomplete. Overthrew it. That stopped the clock with 35 seconds.
As Jones, you say, come on, you guys. Come on. I did everything I could tonight. Get it up there. We got the score on the rock. Hang on. Make it happen. This guy right here, you know, he's just begging for the chance. You can see it. What a game it's turned out to be. I'm real pleased with it. I tell you, I like the way this has been. You know, the defensive coach is probably...
Washington left against the clock. To the right is Kelly Ryan, picked up by Robert Lyon. Being chased, a pillow, stopped him at the 10-yard line. Graham could not get out of trouble. 27, 26, the clock running. And remember, Long Beach State has no timeout. They have to line up in a hurry. Under 20 seconds now. Falling the ball. 15 seconds, 34-31. Rainbows lead by three. 11 seconds, could be the last play. Graham. Back to pass, looking, throws. It is complete.
Lucky at
Shelton. Down he goes, short of the first down. 2 seconds, 1 second, it's over.
There's that last one. The Bulls dodge a big ball. They come from behind, they catch it. Metal, as you said, Jim. And they squeeze it. 34-31. I tell you, I never would have guessed that score. 65 points tonight. And this guy here, what a player. What a game he played. People in this stadium will remember him.
513 yards for Graham. Two coaches congratulate each other. And the team in white, who has come so far to play so well, comes up short to the Rainbows, 34-31.
Knocking and pinging, it can bring out
passing pattern away from 40. He may score. The 35, the 25. Touchdown. What a play. The double clutch. Quarterback sneak, Jones, touchdown.
Two of the big plays in last night's victory for the University of Hawaii come behind in the final moments of last night's game to win 34-31 over Long Beach State. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Jim Leahy, along with head football coach of the University of Hawaii, Bob Wagner. Last night